Hello YouTube. So we are starting Grime. So this is a Souls plus Metroid kind of game, like a Souls and Metroidvania. Came out in 2021, middle of 2021, and they have announced a sequel for this game, which is already in development. So it's a good time to play and see how this game is. Okay, for starters, I start with half health, which is not surprising, and jump, and I don't have a head. Maybe we'll get a head later in the game. Okay, someone praying. I don't think I can talk to this guy. This is not an NPC. Okay, dash and backstep. Very similar to Bloodborne. Absorb. So this is like a parry in the game. As soon as the enemy hits. Alright, I don't think I can go that way. I need a double jump for that. My head is all. So that's an NPC. We need to come back. Absorbing an enemy soul steals their breath. Press R2 to convert a full breath meter to health. Alright, so that's how we gain health in this game. So that's our first area, Weeping Cavity, and that looks like a bonfire or a resting point. Alright, so we can grow or increase our stats. Develop Vessel. Using this checkpoint. acquire traits. So we are at level 1 now. We have 94 souls. An imprinted level M becomes your surrogate or checkpoint. Whenever you are shattered, you will reform at the last created surrogate. Alright, so we still don't have a map of this area. There should be somewhere, something that can sell us the map. We meet Yawn. Get away, you uglies. You gas, beautiful perfection. Misshapen and ugly brethren. Sublime. So this time he gives us a weapon, which is an axe. Usually the first weapon is the weakest, so I'm sure we'll get some good weapons as we go forward. Thank you. All right, so we need to find these beacons in order to get the maps revealed. Okay, so red attacks cannot be absorbed, so either you need to dodge or move away from the red attacks. Ah, shit, I wasn't able to parry at the right time. Alright, let me get to that guy fast. Thank you. Right, so that's our second weapon, Twin Fangs. So that looks like this weapon is gonna come in handy when I need some quick attacks on some bosses because the axe is kind of slow. Okay, so we need to go around and break the wall from the other side. Okay, so if we get hunt points, we can actually gain the abilities of our enemies. So I'm gonna wait for a few hunt points and good enemies and get the good abilities. Is this the boss? Do I have to wake him? So his hands look like the same hands that we have encountered before, and they are super easy to parry. Okay, I guess I need to go on that side. And this is a red attack, so I won't be able to parry this. And now, alright, so okay, so the real boss fight starts now. So with parries, I'm taking a major chunk of his health, so I literally don't have to attack him and risk. I can just parry and win this fight. Alright, one final parry remaining and we should be done with this boss fight. I don't think it's really hard, and the first bosses are usually easier in these games, so... Ardor increases the amount of mass gained from defeated foes up to 100%. Ardor is gained by crushing or absorbing prey. Ardor is lost upon taking damage. So this is like a buff where we get more souls.